Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'll show you how to make a very simple design and then turn it into both an art brush and a pattern brush so you can create shapes with it that allow you to weave together designs like this, and even letters like this, all in Adobe Illustrator. And if you stick with me until the end, I'm going to show you how easy it is to pull out individual little pieces in these segments and change the color of the lines. Now I'm going to be using two basic shapes. I'll be using circles, and we'll take parts of circles, and then I'll be using straight lines. So let's move to a blank document here, and I'll show you how it's done. Now the first thing is to create the design we'll use for the brushes. It'll be the same design and the same size for both of them, so everything will work together seamlessly. So I'll get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and click on the artboard to open the rectangle dialog box and type in 3 inches for the width, tab down and type in 0.1 inch for the height, and say OK. Then I'll move to the properties panel and remove the stroke and change the fill color to black. Click on the artboard to close out the swatches panel and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. Now this rectangle is actually going to be the first line in my design, and I'm going to copy it. I'll hold down the option key and drag down, and as I drag, I'm going to hold the shift key down, and that keeps my copy in the same vertical line as my original. And when I see the word intersect, I'll release my mouse. Now, I see the word intersect because I have smart guides turned on. And if you'll go up to view, you can see where to turn them on right here, or you can toggle them on and off with the keyboard shortcut Command U. Now I need 7 more lines, so with that copy selected, I'll duplicate that using the keyboard shortcut Command D. We'll do that 7 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now you don't have to always use 9 lines, but you do need an uneven number. And these designs are going to have to be made so that they line up end to end. So what I want is the top line and the bottom line to be black, and I want every other one to be white. So I'm going to select the second one, then hold down the shift key so I can select multiple pieces at once, and then I'll go every other one, selecting those, and then come to the properties panel and change the color to white. Click on the artboard to close the swatches panel and select all of the lines and group them. Keyboard shortcut Command G. Now I'm ready to create my brushes, so I'll go up to Window, down to Brushes, grab the Brushes tab and drag and dock it next to the Layers tab, and then come down to the bottom bar and click on the new brush icon, and this opens the dialog box for brushes. I'll choose Art Brush and say OK. I'm going to name this Lines Art Brush. I want to make sure stretch to fit stroke length is selected, and make sure that the direction of your art brush is running parallel with your lines, and then say OK. Now come back to the bottom bar of the brushes panel, click on the new brush icon again. This time I'll choose pattern brush and say OK. I'll name this lines pattern brush. Then come down to these 5 bins and choose the one on the left and click the pull down menu to choose auto centered. And this makes sure that I have the corners I want. I'll leave everything else the same and say OK. Now I have both of my brushes so I can delete my design. Now I'll move over to the properties panel and I'm going to reveal some guides I've set up because I'm going to be creating this first design I showed you, and this is going to help me just get things in place a little faster. Then I'll get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and click on the artboard to open the rectangle dialog box. I'll leave the width at 3 inches, tab down, and type in 3 inches for the height, and say OK. And because I have a closed object that has corners, I'm going to have to use the pattern brush instead of the art brush. So I'll apply the pattern brush, get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and drag this piece over and set it along the guides here. Then I'll get the ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, and click on the artboard to get the ellipse dialog box. And I want a 3-inch circle here, so I'll type in 3 inches, tab down, type in 3 inches, and say OK. Now for a closed object that doesn't have corners, we can use either the pattern brush or the art brush. I'm just going to go ahead and apply the lines art brush here. Then I'm going to get the scissors tool, keyboard shortcut C, because I only need 3/4 of this circle. So I'll click on the top anchor and the left anchor, then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and pull this piece out of the way because we're going to need that in a minute. Now I'll drag this piece over here, and I want to make sure that there's no fill, and there is a fill, so let me come over here and remove the fill. Let's check. This one has a fill as well, so we don't want any fills in any of these pieces. I'll remove the fill here as well. Next, I'll get the line segment tool, keyboard shortcut backslash. I'm going to drag out a line, and it's going to start here and go straight up. So I want to place my cursor right here on that anchor, and I'll hold down the shift key so as I drag, I stay in a vertical line. And I'll just drag a little ways, release my mouse, go to the brushes panel, and apply the lines art brush here. Now, because I started at that anchor point, this is a pretty good match here. Then I'm going to come back and get this other piece to the circle and move it back and add it on. Now, the reason that I didn't just leave this as a whole circle before is because I needed to be able to access that anchor point to add my straight line here. The whole point of this is precision, so you want to make sure that every single line matches perfectly. Now I need another square, so I'll just make a copy of this one. I'll hold down the Option key and drag, and we're going to move this and line it up with this vertical line. And I'll release my mouse to see what this looks like. And you can see this isn't matched up perfectly. So what I'll do is select this square, and I'm going to use my left arrow key and just nudge it enough that these lines are now lined up perfectly. Now, if you do that without first changing your keyboard increment, then when you use your arrow key, your objects are going to jump further than mine did because I've changed the value so that the arrow key just barely moves at all. You can do that by going up to Illustrator, Settings, General, and I have my keyboard increment set at 0.001, which is really small. You probably want to change the value back when you're finished, but this is the value I recommend for this project. So let me just say OK here. Now I don't need all the square, I just need the top and the right side. So I'll get the scissors tool, keyboard shortcut C, and click on this anchor and click on this anchor, and then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and remove this part and delete it. Now I'll get the ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, click on the artboard, and I'm going to create a 2-inch circle and say OK and apply the art brush here. Get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and again, we want to pull out a quarter piece. So I'll get the scissors tool, keyboard shortcut C, click here. Click here, get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and remove this part and delete it. Then I'll take this piece and line it up until it intersects and release my mouse. Now to complete this piece, I'll get the line segment tool, keyboard shortcut backslash, place my cursor on the anchor, hold the shift key down, and drag. Then go to the brushes panel and apply the art brush. Now I want this piece I just added to be under this vertical piece here. So with it selected, I could go up to Object, Arrange, and choose Send to Back. But instead, I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut Shift Command Left Bracket. Then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard to deselect my mouse. Then you can see how it doesn't matter what size your circles are. Because both of these brushes were created with the same size design, they're going to all line up perfectly. Now get the ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, click on the artboard to open the ellipse dialog box and create another 3-inch circle. Say OK. Apply the art brush here, get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and drag this piece over and line it up with the guides. Then I'll hold down the option key to drag out a copy, and I need to make a half circle here. So I'll get the scissors tool, keyboard shortcut C, click on the left anchor and the right anchor, get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I'll pull this piece away, and we're going to drag this over here. Now before, to get my pieces to line up perfectly, I pulled out a quarter of a piece of the circle, and I'm going to do the same thing here. So I'll select this piece, get the scissors tool, keyboard shortcut C, and click here, and click here, then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. We'll pull this out for just a minute so that we can drag this piece over and line it up perfectly. Then I'll drag this quarter piece back in place. Now this other half circle is going to come here on my square. And since my square has straight lines, I don't have to pull a quarter of it out to match up my circle. Now create the next piece, which is going to be a straight line that connects these two pieces. I'll get the line segment tool, keyboard shortcut backslash, place my cursor on the anchor, hold the shift key down so I can drag straight up to the other anchor, and then I'll apply the art brush to that piece as well. Now I have a line that goes across here, so I'll get the line segment tool, keyboard shortcut backslash, and I'm lined up in the center of this circle. I'll hold the shift key down and just drag straight down. Then apply the art brush here. And I'll move this line to the back. So we'll use the keyboard shortcut shift command left bracket. Then I want the lower part of my circle to be behind this vertical line. So I've got to cut the vertical line. I'll use the scissors tool, keyboard shortcut C, and just click anywhere along the line here and here. Get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and select just that part of the line and use the keyboard shortcut shift command, and this time right bracket, to move it to the front. See how easy that is. If you want a piece of your line to be in front of or behind another piece, just clip them with the scissors tool and move them wherever you want. Now with the rectangle, I can drag it out, whereas with the circle, I'm not able to drag because it distorts the shape. So we'll just grab this here and I'll drag the rectangle over to where this line goes underneath the vertical line. Now that you've got the basic idea of how I'm creating the shapes and putting them together, I'm going to speed up the rest of the video. I'll copy the 3/4 circle and rotate it and then move it under this line and move that to the front. And I'll create a line here and apply the art brush, and we're going to move that to the back as well. Now I'll add a straight line here and apply the art brush and move it to the back. Then I've got to make a straight line to finish this section out here. We'll apply the art brush and move that section to the back, but I am going to use the scissors tool and cut a little piece here and move it to the front there. Now we're going to make a 1.5-inch ellipse and apply the art brush to it and cut out a quarter piece here. Pull that away and align that with this straight line. I'll finish out that piece with the line segment tool and an art brush and move that to the back. Then I'll make a straight line, apply the art brush and rotate it. I'm going to put it at an angle here and move that to the back, and then clip a little piece with the scissors tool, move that section to the front, and then I have one more piece to clip and move to the front, and that's all for the design. Now move to the properties panel and hide those guides. And here we have that completed project, which is exactly like the original design. Now it does take a little time to manipulate these different pieces so that they're seamlessly aligned to one another, but it's not hard and it can really be fun. Then for some background color, I'll get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and type in 18 inches by 12 inches, which is the size of my artboard. I'm going to give it a light green color and then go to the properties panel and align it horizontally and vertically and move it to the back with the keyboard shortcut shift command left bracket. Now for what I promised, I'm going to show you how to change the colors of these lines really easily. Let me deselect this on the artboard and then move over to the brushes panel. First, I'll double click on the lines art brush and I'm going to come down to the colorization area and change the method from none to tints and say okay. And I'm going to choose apply to strokes. Then I'll double click on the lines pattern brush and do the same thing under colorization. I'll change the method to tints, say okay, and apply to strokes. Now I'm going to select just one piece, move to the properties panel, and I'm going to change the stroke color. I'll click on the icon and choose red for the color, and Illustrator applies red just to the piece I have selected. And I'm not limited to just one color. I'll select another piece, choose the stroke icon, change this to yellow. I can choose a piece that has the pattern brush applied to it. Let's choose orange for that piece. This was a straight piece. I'm gonna make that orange as well. And come down here, and I'm just going to go around and make some different colors. Now, this piece here is one long piece, so if I select it and change the color, I'm going to be limited to this blue color, and I don't really want this to continue here, so I'll get the scissors tool, keyboard shortcut C, and I'll very carefully click right here and break that up, and then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and come back and choose just this piece here, and we'll change this to a red. Let's continue the red around the corner, and then I'm going to make this blue to complete this corner here. Then I'll speed this up and change all the colors. Now I'm just choosing random pieces here and applying different colors because I want you to see what a difference the look is when you apply different stroke colors to these pattern and art brushes when you change the colorization method from none to tint. But imagine if you planned ahead of time as you created the design, and then you applied maybe only two or three shades of the same color, what a dramatic look you could come up with, because it's just that easy. Well, I do hope you've enjoyed this video and learned some things about using art and pattern brushes to create designs that you can put together to make some beautiful and interesting pieces of artwork. I do want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.